I should apologize. I don't have much to say, and I don't have a voice to say it. So all I can say is I'm sorry, but I'll do the best I can and hope that he will be able to get a little bit of benefit. I remember D-Day well. We were able to take off and zero visibility. They stayed that way until it cleared over 20,000 feet. The 20,000, we got to get there, was earlier than that. And the planes would be popping out of that solid overcast in awkward ways. They've been flying instruments for all of that distance to get climbed that high. And they were disoriented. Everything was confused. So we could not reorganize in the pattern that was laid out. By the time we identified somebody who was a friend and he knew, we developed four flights and flights of four and started out on the mission. Well, it was really a long time because the first mission I flew was over 8 hours, and the B-51 is not a very roomy lounge area. It's almost claustrophobic because we try to have to put the plane on and wear it. It's just enough room if you want to breathe, but it's not if you want to take a deep breath. But anyway, besides, I don't have a lot to describe except that I did get a view of the channel, loaded the ships. It looked like to me that you could walk across. This channel was full of ships. And, anyway, we did our job. We tried to prevent anything moving toward the coast. If the Germans had any type of vehicle, anything moving, our job was to stop it so that the Germans could not reinforce their worksheet in any way. So, of course, that was several days' work. We had to keep on doing it. But I hope that you will excuse me if I will give up from D-Day itself, because I've had very little to talk about. I'm flying around above and viewing, and we did not have much German opposition. It's reported there were only two German planes across D-Day on the day June 6th. We had more than two, so we had a right number. Anyway, my wish, if you'll pardon me and put up with me, I want to tell you the Eddie Simpson story. Eddie was one of my buddies, and we went through cadets together. We were assigned to the same fighter group, B-57, and had many, many experiences during the war. But he had the terminal. Anyway, he was in a crash with a German plane that flew together. But Eddie was able to get out of the jumbled mess, parachuted, and was picked up by the underground. So he was able to fight the Germans with the French underground, which he did well. But he finally got cornered, and the German, with modern vehicles and everything, the underground were trying to get by with only the vehicles they had stolen from the German. Not very dependable. They situation got even worse. The Germans had reinforced their group. They were really making gains on the body of French underground. Well, a couple of the Frenchmen, 80, were on the back of the last truck. So they jumped off, set up a machine gun in the middle of the road. And the little French roads are very narrow, no shoulders or anything. It's just practically two-wheel tracks, and that's where all the road is. And they were able to destroy the lead vehicle that the new Germans were using to. Well, that blocked the entire German force. So it was quite successful, even though it cost the lives of those brave fellows, the two Frenchmen and the Eddie Simpson. I thought that story should be spread to more people. So we've worked to try to get it in all the publications we could, get the stories out. We try to get flowers on the grave twice a year. Eddie's body is buried in Epinal, American Cemetery in France. So we have people taking things, putting flowers on the grave, and had no family. His mother was the only family member any of us had contact with, and she passed. We had no further conversation with the family member. But this deal of the real heroism of the guy to jump off a truck and face the entire German force with a cup of bread, and you knew it was going to be killed by just standing up in front of the force. But they were successful because they stopped the Germans from catching the underground group. And the underground group lived to tell the story again. But to me, such an impression on me that we do feel like the Eddie Simpson story is something that should be available to the public.
Mr. Abishai, why don't you tell your story about chasing the German 109?
Well, the German 109 was not the smartest captain. When you're having airplanes fight, they have any direction to go. I mean, there's no limit to where you can turn your plane and go. And to try to do any damage to him, you've got to get your plane in position to point it at him because all your guns fire forward. So when he flew under the Eiffel Tower, we've actually been fighting from 20,000 feet up. And as we continued to battle, he was not the dumbest one either, because he tried to get. He gave me a good workout, but at 5,000 feet, I got some hits on his engine and started it on fire. Well, that made him nervous. I don't know why. Seemed to get agitated. Decided it would take me over Paris and see if they could get all of the German anti-aircraft guns in Paris, which are more than I can add up to. They're all of them pointing at me, so I say it would happen. Maybe it was not smart, but I got some more hits on him. Then he really got nervous and he just ducked down under the Eiffel Tower. But by then, he's eliminated 50% of the directions he could go. So he set himself up, because it was easier to predict where he would, what direction he would go when he got out. And I was able to be able to get enough hits to destroy him at that point. So he didn't go over a couple blocks until it crashed into the ground. A lot of conversation and talk about flying into that. There's a big lot of room, plenty of room for a fighter. And I've also been able to contact a lot of the people that were around in Paris at that time that saw it. And what amazed me when I thought it came up to my front door in Reno, he said, "My father was in the tower when he went out."
Okay, so now you know where I'm at. My humble story, right? Wow. Okay. Mr. Armistry, thank you very much for sharing.